coach Mzwandile Stick and captain Siya Kolisi. Please raise your hands for questions.
I'm fine. I'm good, thank you. Fake shit. Nothing, like nothing I can do. Nothing I can talk about. Yeah, I'm good. Trained the whole week, which gave me. That's all I needed to, because the doctor said it's all about how much pain you can take, and it can get worse, but it's gonna get fixed anyway. So it's good. It's as best as it can be.
Can you wear any protections?
No. No. They already know what's wrong, so there's no point of protecting it. Yeah.
Rashi said you might look up, end up looking like Poha.
No comment.
Going back to 2 years ago, after the Northwick case and ahead of Ellis Park case, you had spoken about how you guys would not get carried away about what had happened. Is that the feeling at the moment? You're more aware of the August now, second time around?
Yeah, for sure. But we spoke about that that experience, you know, and you can never be too comfortable when you play against the All Blacks, you know. And we know they're going to be a desperate team. You've seen after they've lost against us at Bombela Stadium, they managed to bounce back. That's the quality of a New Zealand team, you know. If you're not at your best on a day, they'll put you away. And also a lesson that we can also learn from Argentina earlier in the championship. Argentina won the first game, and then the second game it was 40 points. So once again, they've got world-class players, and they're well-coached side, you know. So on a day, if you're not at your best, they will punish you. And also, more especially if you look at the changes they've got now in their team, you know, and you look at that back three, you don't really want to give those guys some space and enough time to make decisions, you know, because they will punish you, they're world-class players. So, yes, we did learn from the past, and once again, you can never underestimate an All Blacks team. So, but once again, we've done everything in our power to make sure we're well prepared also for the game.
Siya, can you verbalize how much this means to you? Because obviously, as the doctor said, it's about how much pain you can take. Pain barrier is there. So obviously, this is huge for you.
It's huge for the team. It's not huge for me just alone. It's huge for the whole team. We are in a place that we've never been before as this group in the rugby championship. We've never been in this position before where we've always gone to Australia or won here against Argentina, then go to Australia, lose against Argentina, and maybe get a win in New Zealand. So, and like the Freedom Cup is something that we only see it in pictures or when we walk past it. You know, we've never been able to touch it, and it's big. And also coming back to Cape Town as well, playing here after so many years, you know, and there's so much to play for. We can put ourselves in a very good position for the Rugby Championship. We can win the Freedom Cup, you know, again. All the other stuff is, yeah, and it's not about me. If I wasn't okay, I wouldn't have played, wouldn't have changed anything for the group. I just really want to play the game. I wanted the opportunity, and the dog gave me the opportunity. But the whole week has been about the team, how much. Yeah, it's what we've done to get here. And as coach said last week, you know, it's not being wary of the All Blacks. It's us also putting our front foot forward, because we didn't last week. We had to fight back to win the game. We can't do that this weekend. We have to make sure that we start the way the game they play. The players that they've picked for this weekend, they're clearly showing what they want to do. They want to run the ball. And what are we going to do? And that's what we'll be trying to focus on. What are we going to do as a team to make sure that we start far better than it was last week, and then we see how it looks after 60 minutes?
Okay. So, how reassuring is it to you have the youngsters, Apelele and Sasha, running the track, the show last week, but now you can pull back on guys like Willy and Andre? Just how reassuring is that to the team going into this current match?
I think it's exactly, I think you all remember, Coach Rassi was quite open when he first started with the first meeting we had. He said he wanted to win transformation in squad depth. And he said he can only all do all the other two, he have to win first. And that's where we've been pushing this year. And he's open and honest with the team. And he speaks and he wants to give players opportunities to play, but it's the best way to do it now while you're winning. And the way that you can see Sasha and Fassi in them, they probably have like 4 or 5 games, but 3 of those games, one a game against the All Blacks, one game in Australia, and that's where you test it the most, and that's what we're trying to do. And it's so awesome that Sasha has been able to do that and run the team and control, and he's been the general. Fassi, he was in the group, he went away, and the coach was honest with him. He did everything that the coach asked him to do in the club level. Then he came here, got his opportunity, and you saw what he did last week. And everybody knows Fassi is not Rob, but the coach is trying to make sure that everybody gets a fair opportunity. But we as a group are so proud. Guys that have been here for long and guys that are coming in to see that whoever is put in, that's what you want as a group. If somebody falls, that nobody panics. That it doesn't matter who's coming in. And that's why I always say our biggest competition, our biggest pressure is within amongst each other, not the opposition. Because I know if I don't pitch up for 1 second, Marco Fassadon will take his opportunity. But you won't see that when you see me and Marco. We are amazing people because we're good friends, because we know the team is the most important. But when I get my chance, I must take it with both. And when he gets his chance and he's playing, then I become Addis Avia against him every single training because I want him to be special. So that's what we're trying to build as a group. And we are fortunate that the players that have been selected, we just respond the way that we do because we know me and what I want is not more important. The group is, because what I want, when I'm finished, I'll be gone. But at least I know I've given my best, and the next guy that's coming in is always going to be good and take it to the next level.
Rob?
See, last time you guys played during Cape Town, you know, it was Ireland's hybrid against Wales. It was an incredible atmosphere. Tomorrow, I'm sure there are going to be a lot more All Black supporters than there were Welsh at that time. But are you expecting a very similar type of crowd, you know, amazing atmosphere and just a great occasion?
Yes, I am. I am expecting a great occasion, and we want obviously as many South African supporters as we, but we respect everybody that's coming to watch. We've seen people that flew in from New Zealand, and I think Coach Rusty explained it in one interview. We have to respect everybody. You know, there's reasons behind everything, and it's nice that those stuff is explained to us, you know, why it is like that, and we respect that, and we just want to go there and play as best as we can for everybody, because people pay to come and see us, and we're not only playing, and we want to people, you know, hopefully one or two people can turn after the game and support us again. But we have like no bad feelings, especially after things have been explained by people who lived during the time and things were, so we do understand that, and there's no hard feelings. As long as when we play someone else, they support us.
Coach, Siya speaks about the team not being in this position before. You know, how important do you think it is to not get too carried away and, you know, to keep a cool, calm head and get the job done?
Yeah. I think it's very important. And since the previous weeks, you hear when we talk about we want to develop our game, we want to get better in how we do things. Remember, we've got a new personnel in our coaching staff, you know, so there are certain things that as a team we always want to build in our game. And it's clear and open that you can see even on attack how we're operating under Tony Brown. You know, it's something that is totally different to what we normally used to in the past. And it's actually a nice challenge. And I know one thing for sure, coaching staff and the players, we're so excited with what the other coaches are bringing on the table in our system. So you can never relax, not when you play against the All Blacks. You know, and I think the key thing from my side, like Siya, touch on it. We've never been in a position like this in the past, you know, where you've got a chance. You know how difficult it is to win that Freedom Cup away from the All Blacks, you know. Because remember, you need to win 2 games to get it away from them, do you understand? So, yes, we've been doing well against them, you know, winning 1 game and then they win the 1 game and then they return that Freedom Cup. It's a very special trophy, you know, and if you look at where we are as a country, for example, 30 years of democracy, I think that trophy speaks volumes into what we stand for as a Springbok team currently. So, yes, we spoke about it. And just once again, I know we haven't played a lot of games against the All Blacks here in Cape Town. The last one was in 2017. And now if you look at a team and what we stand for, I think the timing of bringing the game back into Cape Town, you know, like I said, once again, we respect people's opinion. But I know I've got friends that I grew up with you know, that also used to tell me more about the All Blacks. But I know one of the, some of them now, they're in our corner, do you understand? So that's the best we can do. You know, we are given an opportunity to make a difference between the four lines as coaches and players, and that's exactly what we're trying to do. It's going to be a great vibe. It's going to be a great occasion. Once again, I think, Ross, you touched on the last game we played here against Wales. That was one of the special crowd vibe, you know, in Cape Town. So I know one thing for sure. We're playing at home. I know our people will be behind us, and we'll do everything in our powers to make sure that we at least give them a taste of that Freedom Cup.
Siya, the All Blacks have quite a change to their back row. Keeper Blackadder is injured and Wallace Setiti comes in. What do you know about Wallace and what do you expect from him this weekend?
Yeah, he plays for the Chiefs, right? And they obviously, Blackadder is proper. He's got like, it reminds me of Peter Steph, like he's everywhere in the field. He works really hard. I think with Setiti, I think he's also very young guy and he's going to get his opportunity. He's going to throw himself in battle, he's going to attack. But to have a guy like Sam Kane and Adis Avi, I mean, who else would you want to be playing, you know, your cap with? And I think they will be in his ear the whole week, encouraging him. So I have no doubt that, you know, we're going to have a challenge in our hands, especially in the breakdown. It's going to be it was a challenge last week, but I think this week will be even more.
Just to see, from the outside looking in, it looks like something special is brewing with this group of Springboks. And, you know, you've almost been likened to that All Blacks team that dominated for over a decade, where they're winning games that they're not supposed to be winning. Will this game tomorrow be a stepping stone towards that promised land?
Well, I don't know what... Like, for us, it's been the same. We've been trying to reach the same things, but this is different for us. It's a challenge that we have for ourselves. And we spoke about before doing back-to-back big games. We couldn't do it again against Ireland. Now it's another opportunity, but obviously now there's so much on the line for both teams, and we really want to win the Freedom Cup. And there's so many things, the first team to win in four. All that matters, we just need to win. Nothing else matters. We're not thinking that's all. We just want to win the Freedom Cup.
Siya, just yesterday you were spotted, you and Coach Sik were spotted yesterday with the Springbok women's side. You and Nadine Lewis were sort of together. Can you just tell us what you guys were doing exactly in the roles? And it was a Springbok double here, obviously.
Yeah.
Just touch on that, please, as well.
No, we just we went to go watch the ladies train. And I went early. I was in the meeting with them. Had a chat with them because they support us a lot. They support us all the time, you know. And a lot of them, we grew up in the same areas. One of them played in my club with me, and I know what it's like. Well, I don't know what it's like for them, but I've also struggled a little bit, and I know how the women's game is obviously developing. But it needs a little bit more of us as men to be there, supporting, talking about it, so that they can get to the level that we are in. But obviously, rugby is a tough sport to start playing. It needs a lot. You need a little bit of money. You need a little bit of boots, and we're playing in thorny fields and all that kind of stuff. You need grass where soccer you can just play in the street, you know. So went and we watched them train, and then I really love the way Nadine plays, and I have so much respect for her. And I don't think she's seen, there's a lot obviously, but I don't think that she's praised now, because I saw what she did in the sevens. We swapped jerseys yesterday. The jersey is so small. I was told that, I told her it looks like a sample size. She says that I must give it to my daughter or my son. So we just want, we really wish we can do more with them, because they're getting better and better each time. And to think of where they started, and that's what I was telling them, you know, the other teams might be way more developed than you, but you're not playing for yourselves anymore. They might not reach, like as we say, the promised land for them, but the next generation of women might reap the rewards of what they're doing. So they're already doing well, qualified for the Olympics, you know, and now they're going to be playing in the W15, which I'm hopefully going to bring my whole family to go watch them. I think, yeah, it is important that we celebrate them a bit more and then we talk to them about a bit more so their game can also grow.
Justin?
See, sorry, just on that note, truly having them play on Saturday as a curtain raiser ahead of the box at the HL Stadium is a step in the right move.
100%.
Because we now have a sold-out stadium, well, that's debatable, but a capacity big stadium that will have people there hopefully early enough at Office 1 to watch them. So the fact that we can have them play on the same day with you guys surely must be a step in the right
move. No, 100%. We're so excited to hear that and to hear how happy they were about it. And it's important. And I know people love rugby. And I know people of South Africa will take any reason to buy Airy, and that's an opportunity for everybody to go and watch and just go see and get to know them, because I know the South African competition is growing, and I think, yeah, I would really encourage people to go watch them. Because at the end of the day, when they go play in the World Cup, in the W15, they're representing all of us just like we are doing, and they need the same kind of backing, and I encourage people to go and watch them, and I'm sure it will be a good game against the Barbarians.
Coach, you were on the front row seat, you know, going back to that 2017 game. Remember there was an extraordinary passage at the end of the first half, like, you know, 10 minutes end to end. And then also, you know, just that one moment that you guys had where there was a little bit of ill discipline, I think, and they charge or something, and then it was 25-24, you know. So, like, how important would discipline be, and then also boldness in a way?
Yeah, I don't really have a lot of good memories about that game because I wasn't involved in 2017, and probably I've watched that game with the double Branavin and Cokes, a couple of them. Coach. No. I was only involved in 2016. Then 2017, I went to the juniors. But yeah, like I said again, once if you're playing against the All Blacks, you know, most especially the past couple of games you play against them, until I think any team could have still win the games even at the last second. Last week, one step wrong against them, they would have probably put us away and score a winning try at the end because it was very close. And then all the games that we've been playing against them, I think a game that we've probably had clear dominance against them, it was the one at Twickenham. That was the game that we probably pulled away from them. But most of the games against them, it always goes to the last seconds of the game. And I know one thing for sure. With the team they've selected, chances are this goal might also go down there, which is exactly what people deserve, you know. And it's going to be probably a packed, and I know the vibe in Cape Town, people. That's one thing I enjoy about Cape Town crowd is that you can see people are here to have fun. You know, even if sometimes the games are tense, but people will keep on cheering at us. And that's something that picked us up also as a team, you know. So, yeah, memories on 2017, I don't remember much.
Sorry, Greg.
No problem, sir.
I see also on that score, a Bok win on Saturday would give you 6 wins out of the last 8. Some people may say that's a bit of a stranglehold as a player and maybe as a squad member. Does it feel that way?
I don't know. We don't look or talk too much about this. Just won the Freedom Cup. That's all that we're thinking about. I'll think about what you said another time, then I'll answer it next time. But we haven't, honestly, that's why I can't answer it. We haven't spoken about it or thought about it. Our eyes on just this weekend. Then you can ask me all the questions.
Unknown and Inka too, and then if you close our
eyes. Yeah, just to coach Stick, Rassi spoke in the week about your work that you do for the off the ball stuff and the guys on the field as well as high ball and so on. If you look at the All Blacks back three and how do you see that battle going tomorrow?
Do you want water?
Do you want water?
Like this whole week.
You know, like I said again, I think it's clear how they're going to approach the game, you know, if you look at who they've selected, you know. And if you look at the Lustria also, you're looking at the ball players, guys that are short and quick and moving around the park, that will probably, they'll try to keep the ball in play. And with their back three, for example, if you look at a guy like Clark last week, was probably one of the best players when it comes to finishing and probably hurts a couple of our guys the way he runs, you know. But for them to make those big calls where they bring back a guy like Siburis and Talia at wing, you know, after a performance like that from the other guys that played last week, then it shows exactly the mindset they're looking for. I've heard them, they're talking about covering our kicking kicking game, you know, and those guys, I know Siburis for sure. We coach against him many times. I've gone through his profiles, you know. When it comes to speed, you know, and turning and covering all the kicks behind their backs is one of the best, you know. And once again, probably they will be desperate to get 5 points. And we know one thing for sure. That's why they've selected those players, because they try and keep the ball in play. So, yeah, it's going to be a tough one. It's going to be a tough one. But once again, I think these are the moments we live for, you know. And once again, to stand in a chance to win that Freedom Cup, I think that is something that we've been talking about, you know. So we'll do everything in our powers, and hopefully we can also contain those guys at the back.
Siya, you mentioned, Coach, about how, you know, Cape Town's a favourite to play, you know, some of the things with the crowd. But Siya, just yesterday, Rassie said you were in his playing at Newlands and you got chirped about his kater playing at Newlands. So just in terms of a Cape Town crowd and a Cape Town vibe, what are some of your, I guess, favourite and most unique things about playing in Cape Town?
It's too much. It's too much to say. I played there for 11 years. This is where I started my professional rugby career. And yo, everything I know, I've learned here, obviously, and professional world. And some of my good friends I've made there, my family, you know, all started here. It's really a special place. You can't... like, if you're a rugby player, wherever you go, people just excited to see you. And they're excited to help. Like, the other day I went to, I think, World Cup, and I was offered some mousses, everything. It's that kind of community where if you go to a mall, or I said the other day, I don't know who I was talking to, if you are out when you're not supposed to be out, people will ask you, what do you need? You know? And I like that, you know? And people don't hold back. It's... because people care, you know, people care, and they pitch up. I remember people will fill up where you can't, at Newlands, where you can't sit down, where the standing ticket's packed, you know, and that's how much they love rugby here. And they also don't hold back, even with, like, what they said to Rassi. I remember they telling behind the bench, the guys that sit there with the Thomas Moss, telling Scala what's wrong with his body. I'll let him tell you what they said, you know. And they chirp us, eh? They tell us if we lose, how, I can't say the words, K-A-K-A, we are.
As a bit, don't say.
And then, but they show up every weekend. And, you know, when we're doing well, we are the best, they say. And then the next 2 years, yeah, they say what they say. So it's really, really, really special. It's a different... culture, a different atmosphere, and I really loved every single moment, and I wouldn't change the way my rugby, you know, grew up here. It's really special, and I know the people of Cape Town know that, and I think Saturday is not going to be any different, and I think if they could be closer to the field, they would definitely would have loved that. So they let us know how they feel about how we're playing at the time. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it either way. Yeah, cool. The chill. Hotel coach didn't be most lonely pressure. So, hotel account is a change. I go miss a nigga and Jay character. We know. When funu galaga cool, we say then I tete no mutu kesh. No mutu kesh a kafun. Unika bandu iklasha lite. On buzi le. Ufumani is rad mutu ichanda. Mtale na ati. Tifunu kwanza yoni se mengre. Am uzindal. What okay? And then that chima gumfu. That chima gumlesbin. And he. But this villa goes in the right. In this our song, we do kind better directly in Pumblin. And I in Zegi, it was in. I was a machine. Our window. In the song, but not that way. So, therefore, yeah, the money tuba. But they ask, of money tuba, akumbuze ukukhumbula if awuzinikelanga emdlalweni kumbuze ukukhumbula ba hayi bi warrior no funa still lidlala umdlalo senem sebenzi nike nimenzini
senayo ne nickname nje kuthiwa wrong 10 2
yeah okho kunini yakho bani abaqeqeshi xa umdlalo mhlambe umthamalela ngoba indebe ehlabathi ibuzwa kuweni kodwa bekhe watsho naye malungxa yakuba
Siva, Siva, Gamabad, as he has no years, as I remember the thing. Kubalegila, when I can use so, out to Angola Trophy, 13 Dopo, M. South Africa. Maybe yes, in New Zealand, try Pumele, and about Pumele Bavuela and Jeba, Sambi Bawini Trophy. Kuti, he tethered into Kakul, la Trophy, Freedom Cup, and Zange. Sifumane opportunity na sike siphakamise and xa sojonga kule ndawo sikuyo as a country now and what we stand for as a team singamabhokobhoko I think ibalekile ba noko abalandeli bethu sibaphe la taste la Freedom Cup so yona nto is motivator kakhulu abaphakathi evekini and nalanto ukukhumbule ba sagqibela udlala be Cape Town ne All Blacks ngo 2017 and the reasons was uyayazi ba urase becacisile because of a follower following the All Blacks up Cape Town ebininzi kakhulu and bakhona abaguqukeleke tata babuyele ekhaya yeyona nto thina siphilela yona lonto sithi make sure ba ezi reasons zabo babenazo ukuze bawele baye kwela cala sinoko ngoku I think bayabona utshintsho esi olwenzekayo up etimini yethu and uyayibona ba team ebelonga kubantu bonke eyona nto ndithanda yona abokusiya le ndatata ngayo ba bakhona abadlali abaninzi basuka be Cape Town abakule team yethu uyabona so I know personally xaso udlalela kokwenu it's very special enhlizweni yakho so for abafana abasuka be Cape Town land usiyaxhala ngayo ba I opportunities ezinhle basifumana mhlambi kwelicala ke Western Province ngikumbule safika eStellenbosch esemncinci so kubalekile nathi sithi make sure ba siyabadlalela abalandeli bethu and yeah we will do everything in our powers come and just to make sure ba noko abalandeli bethu siyabavuyisa be Cape Town
Stellenbosch
see ya
The color looks me down. No, Andy, right? The lap of the Zense gets in the government of Nins, Munda Milap, in Kulka Kulden and Dinsa, and the Yon and the Balaclay, Kulalam Pokopo, and E decisions in Zense, I mean, and this Tatayo. Funa ukuthi make sure man senda wone right enkwazi odlala kuyo odlala mpokopoko so ingqondo yami lapha like zininzi into esifuna ezizenzile lapha anikwazi ucinga ngaphandle and le match inkulu ibuyisa apha ekapa and siyayazi apha ekapa baninzi abantu abasupporta eli qembu sidlala against lona and siyayazi i-history yayo uba isukaphi and thina siziplayers siya-understand and into esithandayo i-coach bethu bayathetha nathi but nazi reasons why kutheni besupporta eli qembu so siyavuya kakhulu but siyayazi i-vibe yalapha ibantle kakhulu xa sidlalayo and even if nobasupporta thina okanye basupporta bona akho nto irongo emva kwenikenisimini if thina sidlala ngale ndlela sifuna udlala ngayo ndiyayazi for sure if siwinile ngomgqibelo noba umnye noba babini bazazakha ekuqaleni because ekupheleni kwemini namhlanje le nto abantu bebelelwa yona ngala mini thina I think sile team yethu siyawubonakalisa le nto bebelelwa yona yabo and I think ezi World Cup zimbini sizibinileyo kube sinabantu abamnyama nakhaam abayi-7 kule team yokuqala ke isibini benye babeba-8 so siyaphambili but siya-understanda why abantu bekule ndawo sikhulu
kodwa mabagoduke babuyelekhaya
Can you show last one,
quick one? Look, there's one more there. And it's lent to ourselves.
So, one and only means that I go to the father of the John Gill, Eubala, Isabel, Nabalan, Babu,
I want to know what the challenges are. Thina umsebenzi wethu njenge-assistant coaches ukuthi make sure uba siyasupport i-vision yakhe and into endiyithandayo kuye like usiye betshile uba eyona nto ibalulekileyo kuwina qala so wonke umdlalo ophakulela qala lethu bonke baselekte on merit bayaphefoma xa befumana i-opportunity zabo eyona nto isibalulekileyo leyo okwesibini besithethe nge-transformation transformation I know people always black and white transformation is to make sure uba siyayikhulisa iqela lethu silisa phambili yabona and uyajonga indlela ngoku esidlala ngayo even nabantu abakhona kula coaching staff yethu we've got coaches all over around the world yabona le transformation sithatha ngayo ke le not only because of black and white we've got now uTony Brown who's helping us with the attack ane uyayibona ne transformation ba siyapi ngendlela esi-attacka ngayo yabona so thina singabaqeqeshi even ne major last week umsebenzi wethu we've got plans xa kufuneka uyodlala ku-game plan siyayazi xa inga xa singa izinto zingenzeki kakuhle siyayazi apho isiphoso zikhona yabona kulapho ke thina ke umsebenzi wethu ezikho sithi make sure uba sifocuse kwirugby sifocuse kule nto ofuneka siyenzile sikwazile noko ukuthetha izinto half time last week noko ibehavior yakwazi utshintsha also xa sowubona phaa kwi-60th minute indlela esitshintshe ngayo with i-impact yethu esebhentshini so umsebenzi wethu thina kuthi make sure that sifocuse erugbini and osiya bayayazi iplayers ebaleni bayo yinto le kufuneka yenzekile and I feel like last week khona ixesha ba besingakhange sizenze kakhe izinto besiziplanile but kodwa ke la last 16 minutes egame I think zonke into zahamba kakhe and also credit must go to kulento kwibhentshi yethu bakwazi ufaka i-impact
futhi enye into I was saying in English because also for us what they do ukushasi like people say transformation is putting bad players in the team but for us they put guys in the team who are good enough to be there but then the upskillers like when I became captain coach Rasi has known me since I was 18 years old he knows that I will probably struggle at the beginning because I was shy but well, this is a big thing and I was very scared and then he made the pressure points he made everybody a leader in the team so that I had one job and my only job was to talk to the ref and manage the team's discipline so each guy had a role So I'm growing, everybody else is also growing. Now we have so many leaders in the team. Then outside that, in the past they would say black guys are not good at high balls. Coach Rasi picked black guys and colored guys at wing. Coach Stick teaches them every single time are those guys. He calls them the flyers. They're just flying after every training session. So each skill, like man, when I used to play, everybody known me for my running game. Then my game changed. I had to tackle, do breakdown, run back. They coached me that. Then I became that. That's what I love doing. You don't just put people there and say, go, and then you have one bad game, and then some guys you never see. That's what happened in the past. But now we are well-equipped, and we are confident, and we can go out there and play. And the guy next to you trusts you. He knows you. You're not here just because of your skin color. You're here because you've worked hard, and you've showed him in the weekend. You've earned his respect. And that's what this management team has done differently to everybody else. And the most important thing, they've been open and honest about the team, to the team, and said, we're going to win. We have to have a certain amount of black players in the group, where in the past it was hidden. It wasn't really to be spoken about, you know, where you, as a player, you don't know where you stand. He says, no, this team is losing, but I have to have this kind of... Now. And we knew that, and we made it work as a team. Like, the honesty is the most important for any player. Whether you... If you and Coach Rasi sits there and says, I think this guy is going to play this weekend because I think he's better. He's this, this. In front of everyone. The back-to-back stuff is not there. And then I don't wonder as a player. I know exactly what's happening. So that has made us buy into it as players. Sometimes you don't like what the coach says, but you buy into it.
Have you guys jumped a lot? So would you like another question?
No, it's good.
Happiness.
Thank you. Very much.